was asked to do this for BBQ TV. This is Mary Walker, Gary Baker, and I'm Rita Baker, and it's our 100th contest. Okay, go ahead. I do solemnly swear to objectively and subjectively
evaluate each barbecue meat
that is presented to my eyes,
my nose,
my hands,
and my
palate.
I accept my duty
to be a 4th annual National Barbecue Cup Cumming Georgia judge.
So that truth, justice,
excellence in barbecue,
and the American way of life
may be strengthened and preserved forever.
Do it on purpose.
I know it. I would too.
What do you think?
Very good.
Now, did he give you enough to where you're sure you tasted?
He may have had a brief.
I don't know. I may have to reconsider.
How am I going to do this, Karen?
That makes me wish I was judging.
Okay, most of the five entries were comparable, but I like number 4 the best, and I like number 3 the least.
Okay. I did like number 4 the best. I thought it was the tastiest, not too hot, but it was spicy and tender, and number 3 was my least favorite.
I somewhat disagree. I like them all. However, number 4 was slightly overdone, or at least my piece was. All of it was excellent.
I like number 1 the best, and my least favorite was probably number 5. Mine was just a tad overcooked.
They were all good entries. I think my favorite was number 1. It had a really good flavor and was really juicy. My least favorite was number 2. It had an off taste to it.
To me, number 1 and number 2 were a little tough. My number 1 was a little dry. Number 2 did have an off taste to it. My favorite of the 5 was number 4 and 5, they both had a little sweet taste, weren't too spicy.
That looks good.
There you go.
I'm going to auction these two off.
Yeah.
What are you hanging?
No.
No?
No.
Okay.
I thought rib number 1 was an excellent entry. It was cooked just right. The meat was tender. It was pulled clean off the bone. And excellent entry. Number 2, likewise, was a very good entry. It had a good flavor to it. It could have been a little bit more tender, but it was a very good entry. Number 3, I was really disappointed in it. My particular rib for number 3 seemed to be way overcooked because it just fell off the bone when I picked it up. And the meat, oddly enough, was tough. It was dry and tough, but yet it was so overcooked that it was falling off the bone. I thought it was a strange combination there. I think number 4 was my biggest excitement and biggest disappointment because I thought the meat itself was cooked perfectly. It came off the bone clean. The appearance was excellent. The tenderness was excellent. But when it came down to the taste, the sauce for me had a very funny wang to it. I don't know, it was some type of off-flavored sauce, and I was really disappointed in the sauce. Otherwise, the meat, the entry, I think, could have been a 180. Now, the fifth one, it was a train wreck. It was way too tough, way undercooked. Didn't have any hardly flavor to it. I don't know. That person needs to go back to the practice board, I think. But overall, ribs number one and two were great. Number four could have been great, except for the sauce. Number three and number five, they need to go back to the drawing board.
Can I get this down? Ribs up there and cut? Because I need to cut boards for that.
Okay.
Here, set this pan up there, because I may need that when I get it to cut. Yeah, set it up here for a minute.
How are you, sir?
Well, I'm between you and this other guy over here. I got a delicious truck, too, and this sauce.
Well, we can put a little sauce on it. I would say we can put a little sauce on it. You try it with a little bit of sauce.
No, I liked it. I liked it.
Don't throw your cup away, dude. You want to try the sauce?
Oh, you mean you have some with some sauce?
No, I'll put a little on there.
You put sauce on there.
All right.
Put just a little bit in the cup, Jack. You got some there?
What I'm looking for.
No.
Well, I picked number five is my favorite one. And number four is my least favorite one. And the reason I picked number four as the least favorite is because it was tough and it was very salty. And this one was very tender, very flavorful. And I eat it. It's very good. I mean, I didn't get but just a small piece, but I enjoyed the whole bit of it, and I don't usually eat the whole thing. But it was a very good piece of meat. Executed properly, cooked properly.
All right, my least favorite was number four. Tenderness, couldn't really pull the sample apart. It was not tender enough. And taste was my least favorite taste of the group. Five, I'll go with Mike on that one. I like the taste of number five, and the tenderness was there as well. Overall, a good group. But if I had any of these in a restaurant, I'd probably like them, except for that tenderness I mentioned.
Number one and number five had the best taste, and number four was very tough, very dry, with no flavor to it. And the tenderness on some of them, it was like the money muscle was almost overdone, and then the pulled part was just about right. So it was kind of a toss-up on them. But overall, they were pretty good, except number four.
Overall, I liked number five and number one. Five being my most favorite, with number one a little behind there, but some of the fat didn't render out of the money muscle. And I have to agree with my fellow judges, number four was extremely dry, extremely bland, and the bark itself was very tough to even break through.
I went with number three today. The sample was nicely sauced, had a great taste, had a nice tenderness to it, and I'm going to agree with my other fellow judges on number four. Bland, tasteless, I guess you might say, and very, very tough piece of meat.
How's that look?
This is tipped up. I want this pushed back down here. I want it bent the same way the rest of it was.
Oh, good.
All in all, a very good plate of brisket. The first one's pretty good, a little bit overcooked. The second one, phenomenal. Good tenderness, great flavor. Third one's a little bit dry. Fourth one is, once again, a little bit dry, really good flavor. The fifth one had a little bit of a sweet taste to it, kind of unusual, but once again, very good. The sixth one, tender and moist, and good flavor. Not unhappy at all with our turn-in.
Yeah, absolutely. All in all, was a great cook from all the guys out there. Number one, a little bit a little bit off, but number two was absolutely incredible. Just absolutely enjoyed that one. A few of them had some different tastes, but all in all, an amazing entry. Brisket was very good today.
I don't know that I can go through each individual. I will say number two was the best. And this, overall, this is the best brisket I've had in any competition. So it was very, very good. Yeah.
Yep, I concur. It was a excellent category. Number two was a clear winner, but all of them were fairly good. Number three, a little bit on the fatty side, but it tasted all right. So I think the best category today.
It's very good.
Great brisket category. Number two easily was the best brisket I've had so far.
I thought number two was excellent. It had the taste and the tenderness. It had a sauce on the top that didn't overpower the meat flavor, which is what we look for. And also we had a couple of good entries, but number two definitely the best.